Flying up. Cross. Flips one through center ice, and that puts the Flyers offside. And I'll tell you, they can't do anything right now. Now Lindros and McSorley are going to go. We saw this possibly shaping up earlier. I don't know why the linesman don't just let him go.
Oh, yeah.
What's the problem?
Well, Lindros doesn't have his gloves off yet. But McSorley, early in the game, in fact, it was the first shift, was run over by Lindros. Didn't like it. Got slashed in the second period by Lindros. Didn't like that. And this is the time for payback. Only 2 minutes to go in the game. You're up 3-0. Even the score, and that's what Marty does.
It's unfortunate this is the final meeting between these two teams this season. Unless, of course, well, I don't even want to say when they could possibly meet again. There would only be one possibility. That would be in late June. Here's another look at how this started. Lindros just coming around. Oh, Marty gave him a little jab.
Ooh,
and got it right in there.
A nice right jab, too. This also could be a little payback for Eric Lindros taking on Todd Gill, who's definitely smaller, 6 feet, 190 pounds. Boy, that's a vicious left jab, right jab. I don't think Eric wants to go with Marty at this point. Both players, though, going to be off the ice and in their dressing rooms for the remainder of this game. Wayne Cashman has to be frustrated. They go into Toronto and lose a game there 3-1, and then just get completely embarrassed at home by the San Jose Sharks 3-0. I don't want to be a Philadelphia Flyer. There we see Lindros in close. Oh, wow. That looks like Mike Tyson. Is he going for his scalp?
I don't know. It looks like he was trying to bite.
Ooh, yeah. Marty's head comes up really quick, so that's why I think he might have got a couple of his canines into him.